Hello everyone, in this video we will see about runway length correction, especially for altitude, temperature and gradient. In the last video we saw how to calculate the basic runway length. So we had these three assumptions: that basic runway length, we assume that it is at mean sea level, and we also assume a standard temperature of 15 degrees Celsius at mean sea level, but whereas at the airport the temperature could be different. And also we assume a level gradient, that the gradient never changes, there is no ups or downs even by 1 meter. So these are the three basic assumptions considered, but these three will always vary. As you can see, when we go up, when the altitude increases from mean sea level, as you go up, the air density reduces. So as you keep on going up, air density would have reduced very much. So when the flight tries to take off, the lift provided on the wings will be very less. So you will need more power to take off. Hence you will require more speed, and hence you will require a longer runway. Maybe at mean sea level, if the flight was able to take off sooner, when the air density reduces, you will need much more power and speed so that it can lift off the ground. So as you go up the altitude, you will need a longer runway. Temperature also has the same effect. As temperature increases, the air density decreases. So because of that, again you will need more power and all that. And another thing is gradient. Suppose there are ups and downs in the runway, not by this much, but to an extent there will be ups and downs in a runway. So when there is steep gradient, you will consume more energy, hence you will require more speed on the ground, and hence a longer runway. In the next slides we will talk about how to apply these corrections and what are the equations associated with it. We will also solve some numericals based on it. So what does altitude or elevation correction say? It says that 7% increase for every 300 meter rise in elevation above mean sea level. Let us say our airport is at a elevation of 600 meter above mean sea level, and let us say the runway length is 2000 meters. So how to apply this 7% increase? We see first runway length 2000 into 7% increase, that is 7 by 100 for every 300 meter rise in elevation. You know it is 600 meter above elevation, above mean sea level, sorry. So it is 7% for every 300 meter, and here you have up by 600 meters, so it's in the numerator. So if you solve this, you will get an answer of about 280 meters. So the runway length should be 2000 plus 280, which is nothing but 280 meters. So this is how we apply correction for elevation. Now let us see about temperature. So first of all, what we need to know is how much is the standard temperature at elevation. Let us say at 600 meter, what is the standard temperature which you can observe? Usually the airport temperature might be different, but we need to know what is the standard temperature. So that is nothing but temperature at mean sea level minus 0.06065 into elevation. That is, if the temperature at mean sea level was 15 degrees Celsius, minus 0.0065 into 600, that will be the standard temperature at elevation. And what is the airport reference temperature? So that is the actual temperature which you can observe at the airport. So they have a formula for that. It is TA plus 1 by 3 into TM minus TA. Let us say July is the hottest month of the whole year for that particular airport, that area. So in July you will have data for July 1, July 2, 3 and so on. So whenever you measure the temperature, there will be a maximum temperature which you will observe in the afternoon or something. It will be 42.5 degrees Celsius, or another day it will be 40 degrees Celsius and so on. Another is the average temperature. In night there will be lesser temperature, so you average across the 24 hours, you will get something like 24 degrees Celsius, and so is the data. So here TA is nothing but average temperature of the hottest month. So you take average of all this, that will average of average temperature of the hottest month. So if this works out around 24, TA will be 24. And TM is nothing but monthly mean of maximum daily temperature of same month. So every day will have a maximum daily temperature. You take the mean for it similarly. Let us say it works around 40. So TM equal to 40. So if you apply these here, and you will get the airport reference temperature. So what is the correction to be applied? It is nothing but 1 degree increase for every 1 Celsius rise in airport reference temperature. It is nothing but runway length into 1/100, that is 1%, for every 1 degree rise in temperature. So let us say airport reference temperature is TR minus ST. For every 1 degree rise, you have 1% increase. And when you apply the formula, when you apply these two formulas, first you apply the altitude correction, then you go for the temperature correction. So when both of these corrections put together, they should not be more than 35% of basic runway length. If it is more than 35%, ICAO suggests that you should do in more depth analysis. Next correction is the gradient correction. So gradient correction says that you should increase your runway length by 20% for every 1% of effective gradient. Effective gradient is nothing but, if suppose this is the runway and you have points like this, this is at 99 meter mean sea level, this is at 101 meter, this is at 100, and let us say this is at 98 meter, and the length of the runway, let us say it is 1000 meters. So it is nothing but maximum difference in elevation between highest and lowest point. So 101 is the highest point and 98 meter is the lowest point. So 101 minus 98 is nothing but 3 divided by total length of runway. So this is the effective gradient. So for every 1% of effective gradient, you increase by 20. Into length of runway into, here it is 3 by 1000 into 100, that much percentage, effective gradient percentage. So you have 0.3. So this is the correction for gradient. This is a numerical which was asked in GATE 2017. So they are saying that a runway is constructed according to ICAO recommendations. So they have given the elevation and the airport reference temperature and also the effective gradient. And this is the length of the runway, which is 2000 meters. So when you apply sequential corrections, pay attention to this, sequential corrections, what is the length of runway after being corrected for temperature? So the sequence goes like altitude, temperature, and then gradient. So this is the sequence in which we apply the corrections. So temperature comes second. So at this point, what is the corrected runway length is the question. So first we have to apply correction for altitude. So it is 7% increase for every 300 meter rise in elevation. So you know length of runway is 2000 meters. into 7%, 7 by 100 into for 535 meters, and this is 300 meters. So 7% increase for every 300 meters. So if you solve this, you will get 249.66 meter. So length of runway after correcting for altitude is 2000 plus 249.66 meter. So you will get 2249.66 meters. Now you want to know, you want to apply the correction for temperature. So you know it is 1% for every 1 degree rise in temperature. So you have the runway length after correcting for altitude is almost 2250. 1% increase for every 1 degree rise in temperature. So airport reference temperature minus standard temperature at elevation. So here they have given the airport reference temperature as 22.65 degree Celsius, and you don't know the standard temperature at elevation. You have to calculate that. So it is nothing but temperature at MSL, that is at mean sea level, what is the temperature, minus 0.0065 into elevation. So this is the formula, and you know that at mean sea level we assume the temperature to be 15 degrees Celsius, minus 0.0065 into 535 meter is the elevation here. So if you solve this, you will get approach 7.53 degrees Celsius. So standard temperature at elevation is nothing but 11.53. So if you solve this, you will get approach 246.8 meters. So the length of runway after correcting for temperature is 2249.6 plus 246.8. It is approximately 2500 meters. So the answer is option C. Here you don't apply the elevation correction, because according to sequential correction they want at for temperature. Now let us solve one more problem. So here they have given runway length corrected for elevation is 3670 meters. So they have already given the corrected length after elevation, and they have given the monthly means of maximum and mean daily temperature for hottest month of the year. So what is the final corrected length after temperature effects? So this 3670 is already applied for altitude correction. Now you have to apply temperature corrections alone. So you know airport reference temperature is nothing but so here you have monthly means of maximum and mean daily temperature. Mean daily temperature is TA, 18 degrees Celsius. 18 plus this is 27. Maximum temperature for hottest month of the year. You get that mean, which is nothing but 27 minus 18 divided by 3. So this will be approach 21 degrees Celsius. And you also need to know the standard temperature at elevation. So at MSL you have 15 degrees Celsius minus 0.065 into, it is 450 meters above sea level. So if you solve this, you will get about 12.08 degrees Celsius. Now what is the length after correction for temperature effects? So it is 3670 into 1% increase for 1 degree centigrade rise. So 21 minus 12.08 into 1 by 100 into runway length will give you the correction for temperature. So if you solve this, you will get about 327.4 meters. And you know it is 3670 runway length. If you add these two together, you will get the corrected runway length. So this is approximately 4000 meters. So the correct option is option B. Thanks guys for watching the video. In the next video, we'll see some basics of taxiway and how to find the radius of exit taxiway. Also, we'll focus on the optimum location for exit taxiways. Thanks once again.